midomo midomo babera bajikuba
bami mwacha bwe
aba midomo midomo babera bajikuba
bami mwacha bwe
aba midomo midomo babera bajikuba
bami mwacha bwe
aba midomo midomo babera bajikuba
bami mwacha bwe
mwana wangu vumuka banange kwemanyi simanyi obana batya ayogera mingi nyo mama dala tulemye kuchalo.
Yeah, just like we promised, we say, we're going to bring you into our world, the Gando Boys world, and look through the making of all these videos that make up the whole Dance to the Twins collection that we recently remastered. Now, many of you were born to these songs, many of you were... you gave birth to these songs, many of you got married to these songs, so we thought it would be only fair for us to bring you in and take you back in time so you can relate. You have these videos, you know, many years ago, 20, 15 years ago, so you can look back into what was behind the scenes of these songs and also get a feel of all the of all the experiences, details, and of course
action.
The shake.
Yeah, the pain. Speaking of which, I think we should start with Modomo.
Whoa,
Modomo. Was a big hit.
Yeah. Modomo was
apparently, because we never really knew
how it affected
how
you
it,
guys.
It affected
but
you.
I mean, it goes to be big, you know why? Because this is one of the songs that was also featured in the BBC primetime drama.
Oh yes,
you know,
oh yes.
So, I mean, but the original, now we're talking about the original, Modomo, take it away, bro.
The making, actually, when we talk about the making, let's speak about location. Location was, I think Modomo was in about three places. We shot Modomo at the airport in Redhill.
Yeah, London Redhill.
Yes, and then we had a car garage.
Yeah.
The car garage is where it was the opening scene. And then we had the London streets. Now the London streets, we had, this was a very interesting time because the London streets had a very beautiful cast. We had Miss Jamaica. Because I remember when, I think she pecked you, she kissed him.
She gave you, I got the royal peck.
From
the,
Miss...
The beauty queen peck.
From Miss Jamaica, UK.
You know why I'm laughing, just to catch you short. Why I'm really laughing is remembering the man behind the camera. But anyway, carry on.
And then we had one of our boys, Wilson. That dude has been there for a while. Then we had a couple of UK models that were really involved. Then we went to the house. Now the house was a very interesting point of it. We had some Swedish models. We had Mr. Playboy Wilson over there, you know, and we had Sarah. She had to go to school for about a month to learn how to speak the language,
the
opening statement.
Hello?
Story to say, dear you.
Oh my God,
they love
a couple.
Ah. Kali. Temwali tewali abo no zemba tunulira nabakula no nuli mulundi ogwasemba ku video yabwe naye kati bayikabe bayi nti bachakolera na wamu
olemba
because Biggie's part was he was
ayogira ku Biggie abantu bayizo okubula you talk about Biggie better. this is a low bro Moses. He's the one that actually he's in the opening shot of the video.
Did, yeah.
But most interestingly was the way it all came together and how you guys then saw the final product and got to enjoy it. Kumanga, you know, when it came home, it really hit big.
You know, funny enough, is people adapted this.
Yeah.
One of the signatures of that
of the,
video,
of the song,
especially the opening scene. Tracking. We didn't have that. Actually, it was very expensive because I remember we used the Sam Croft Pro Aggressive skates.
Probably one interesting thing is about the actual story of the song and who we were trying to hit and type. You see, we are very good as a people in fabricating stories and exciting. It's malice and hearsay and. So there's this particular guy carrying a fucking dog. atawana ngayogera kuza mangayo gede nyo aga pogera na kutuka mbabu yinza kubira nga tulo
na omulina no na omulina yeah
So, you know, at the back of it, and then it involved an interview, you know, into naturally, things that we usually tend to hate about each other, and we thought we should call it out, and this is how this song came
out. Yeah, it was so beautiful. We had the whole swag in there. I mean, we had, by then, there were things called the throwbacks, white tees. We had trainers.
Maybe you're not American culture, but you know what? The trick is we really wanted to get through to, because initially, before even getting into this act, we had a band called The Culture Beat. Now, we knew exactly where we wanted to go with our art and how we wanted to promote our culture. But in order to establish ourselves, we had to adapt the American sort of
hip-hop culture
for us to be accepted and understood pretty well. So just in case you're wondering why we had to take it that side, our audience appreciated and understood this culture so well. So this is why we got Danny's expertise in everything he's been explaining and wrapped it all up into creating a brand that was very much accessed, but behind it was the talent, was the art, and we were trying to gather momentum to make sure that we would get where we are today. That's who we are today as the Ganda Boys.
You won't believe, exactly, you won't believe that all of this was shot with one camera. It was a one-man camera operation. How great. It was incredible. Mudomo. Mbuwaba kuba.
Proud of it.